In this video, I'm going to explore just how far some fruit and vegetable produce has traveled to a supermarket in Canada in January. We like to think our food is grown not too far away, but that isn't always the case. The trend in the last decade has actually been a decrease in Canadian fruit farms and vegetable acreages. As Canada's population increases, so does produce consumption, but Canadian fruit and vegetable farms just aren't keeping up. Agriculture Canada, on their website, states Canadian fruit farms decreased from 8,329 in 2006 to 7,845 in 2016. Consumption increased while production decreased. So while Canada is still producing some of its own produce, a lot of it keeps coming in from other countries. Let's look and see where some of the common produce items we all buy in the supermarket come from, using Winnipeg as a middle point in the country. Tomatoes are a bestseller in any supermarket's produce department. Many of the tomatoes we eat often do in fact come from Canada, but in the winter, a lot come from the USA too. According to the Real Canadian Superstore's website, they can also come from a variety of other places, including Belgium, the Dominican Republic, Spain, Israel, Jamaica, Mexico, the Netherlands, or Vietnam. Onions, specifically sweet onions, also have a number of places of origin. Sweet onions sold in the winter in Canada are actually often grown in Canada, but Canada can't keep up with demand. So to make up the difference to feed hungry Canadians, supermarkets also bring onions in from countries like Brazil, Switzerland, China, Colombia, Costa Rica, Ecuador, France, Honduras, India, Jamaica, Mexico, Nicaragua, the Netherlands, Peru, or the United States. That's quite the travel list just to get some sweet onions. Now, while tomatoes and onions have a multitude of countries importing them into Canada, other types of produce come from a specific area or only a few nations. Bananas are a favorite snack for young and old people alike. The amount of bananas sold at any Canadian supermarket is staggering. You just have to look at the size of the banana display to realize just how many of these yellow power foods people are actually buying. Canada doesn't really grow any significant amount of bananas. Yes, it is possible to grow bananas in a greenhouse, but there just hasn't been any large operations growing bananas in Canada yet. So we import most every banana we eat. Bananas eaten in Canada come mostly from South and Central America, Colombia, Costa Rica, Ecuador, and Puerto Rico. Quite a distance, but from one general region for Canadian consumption. A lot of garlic is grown in Canada, but if you're buying based on price, China is the main source for garlic in Canadian stores. China seems like a long way to bring a perishable item, but thousands of tons of garlic pass Canadian customs every week meant for our supermarkets and your kitchen. Chinese garlic can be a bit of a concern. China doesn't have the same pesticide and herbicide laws as Canada regarding crops, and some people are getting worried about what exactly has been sprayed on their food. But China continues to dominate the garlic imports based not so much on quality, but on price. The price of bulk Chinese garlic is really difficult to beat, and that seems to be the bottom line for most Canadian consumers based upon how much Chinese garlic is available for sale in our supermarkets. Avocados are incredible. People spout off about the health benefits of avocados all the time, but they're not just a health food. Fresh, ripe avocados are also the most essential ingredient in guacamole. Avocados come from what is probably the most varied locations of any produce in Canada. Superstore alone lists 26 possible countries that the avocado you buy today might be sourced from. That's a lot of places. Are you ready for the avocado's origin tour? Let's go! We start with Canada. Yes, there's some avocados grown in Canadian greenhouses commercially, but we don't even come close to meeting demand. The majority of the avocados we eat come from places like, are you ready? Australia, Brazil, Belize, Chile, Colombia, Costa Rica, Dominican Republic, Ecuador, Spain, Guyana, Haiti, Israel, India, Italy. Now remember, these are just the countries we get avocados from, and we're only halfway done. Then there's South Korea, Mexico, of course, Mexico is the land of guacamole, New Zealand, Panama, Peru, Thailand, Turkey, Taiwan, the United States, Vietnam, and South Africa. With so many possible sources for avocados, make sure you take a look at the sign in your produce section to see where your next avocado actually came from. There aren't any pineapple trees in Canada, not a single one. Even the best greenhouse technology hasn't been able to grow a single pineapple tree in Canada. And that's because pineapples don't grow on trees. Pineapples are grown on the ground, in a field. Yep, no trees. Pineapple farms are mostly a Costa Rica thing. Costa Rica is the world leader in pineapple exports, and odds are the last juicy pineapple you ate came all the way from Costa Rica. Don't think it's a small independent farmer though. The pineapple market has been consolidated and sewn up by monopolistic mega corporations like Del Monte and Dole for decades. They control and rule over most of this market. Now, when I say oranges, everybody thinks Florida, and that's true to some degree. But the fresh oranges you buy may have just come from Brazil these days. Brazil produces about 30% of the world orange production now, followed by the USA. Not just Florida, but California too. And then, of course, China. China has been growing in orange exports, especially mandarins. Canada has a few citrus greenhouses, but they amount to nothing more than a few independent experiments. This map shows where commercial orange farmers around the world are concentrated. Imagine the cost to refrigerate and transport this produce thousands of miles to your local supermarket. Think about how much food goes bad and gets tainted in transit just to be thrown out. Not to mention the volume of petroleum needed to bring this produce to market from across the globe. The amount of unnecessary people who profit from this food transit chain is ridiculous. And guess who pays for that? You do. At the supermarket cash register. Here's a little secret though. Canadian supermarkets and produce warehouses actually pay a premium for locally grown produce. 10 to 20% more, and we'll buy Canadian first. The demand is there, just waiting for someone to rise up and take over this market for hungry Canadians. Canadians want food grown by Canadians, and have been screaming for this for decades now. We need to encourage Canadian entrepreneurs to invent profitable commercial greenhouse technology that is ROI sensitive on four-season greenhouses that can grow year-round in harsh Canadian winters using new heating technologies that are profitable. We can grow more here for less cost. We need better quality fresh food and more local employment. My YouTube channel, Simple Tech, discusses many commercial greenhouse ideas to build and heat affordably. Please check it out if you see an opportunity to break into an enormous marketplace, begging you for your product with almost no Canadian competition. There's a fortune to be made in so many areas of produce, just waiting for someone to take it. If you liked this video and videos like this, you can actually manipulate YouTube's algorithm by subscribing and hitting the bell. Smashing that like button doesn't hurt either. By subscribing and hitting the bell or hitting the like button, you tell YouTube these are the kind of videos you want more of, and YouTube will suggest more videos like this for you to watch. So hit the subscribe button and the bell if you want to learn more on this kind of topic. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to check out my other videos. See you next time.